I think I can promise you that it will work its way into your very souls. As you look back on the time you came here as a young person, full of ambition, full of idealism, great thoughts of the future, and now you come back decades later, having put in your 4 years here, having been educated the best that this place has to offer, having been filled with idealism, and then have to go out and face the realism of our lives, where every day is not a victory, and problems abound, and we have to rely on faith and the guidance of our Lord to bring us this far. But here you are. You have come this far. And I can tell you the pride as an educator that I feel that you have come back to celebrate the 4 years you spent here learning how to live, learning what to value, learning how to love as a young person, learning how to be true and faithful, learning all those wonderful gifts that make you a good human being, and to point you forward to a wonderful life, which I'm sure the great majority of you have enjoyed over these intervening years. As I get older, I find that I get down to one prayer. It's a simple prayer, 3 words, and it's a very reasonable prayer, because as we read in the gospel today, when Jesus left his apostles, he told them, don't be afraid, don't be worried, don't look around in fear. I shall tell you one thing, I'm sending you the Holy Spirit, and he will tell you how to live. He will tell you what a Christian life really is. He is the third person of the Trinity, and he will be with you all the days of your life. And if you ever have a problem, you can do what I tell my apostles to do. A simple three-word prayer. Come, Holy Spirit. And for all of you graduates, if I have only one word of advice, no matter where you live, how your family has come, what problems you have faced and some of you still face, no matter what the problems and obstacles that try to say you can't be a great Notre Dame Christian man or woman, I say to you, you can, and you are. You keep that moving simply by saying, every time you have a doubt, every time you have a fear, every time sin beckons you in a very tantalizing way, every time you worry about the future, even about eternity, I say to you, don't worry. Be at peace. You're Notre Dame people. When things seem to go wrong, you have a perfect comeback. And it's only those 3 words, come Holy Spirit. And I say those words over all of you today, knowing that the Holy Spirit will not only show you how to live, no matter where you are, no matter what your problems, no matter what your opportunities, he will not only show you, he will help you, he will be with you, and there never will be a problem in your life that you can't solve, as long as you're willing to say that simple prayer, come Holy Spirit. Because when you say that prayer, the whole power of God comes upon you. The grace of God, which is infinite, is yours. You are filled with optimism because nothing is greater than God. And if you're working with God and standing with God and doing his work, I can tell you in all honesty, this is infallible advice. It can't fail. So, a simple message to bring back from reunion is a message that I'm sure you've heard many times before, and yet it's so simple, it sometimes may seem too simple. because it's based on the Word of God. And I say to you that wherever you are, whatever your problems today, we all have some. Whatever the opportunities that beckon, whatever the failures that maybe want to flag you, and they don't have to because they're behind you, I simply say to you, be of good heart. Be Notre Dame men and women who have confidence. Know that you can face the future, whatever it holds, and know that you're going to come out on top because you have that wonderful weapon in your hands. Come, Holy Spirit. And I can't close without telling you you've got something else. All of you are sons and daughters of Notre Dame. That means that when you look up at that golden figure on the dome, it's not just another figure among thousands in this world. It's the figure of our mother, our heavenly mother. And we are her kids. We belong to her. We're Notre Dame people. And she is with us in a way that we can't imagine. And it's not just when we stop by the grotto and say, I have this problem or that, or I need a little help here or there. Wherever you are, you can't leave this globe without knowing that she is with you. And that no matter what may plague you in life, no matter what may discourage you, no matter what may say, you're not going to make it. I tell you in her name, you are going to make it. You are Notre Dame folks. You are a family. She is our mother. She presides over this campus with her golden figure, but she presides over our lives with her heavenly help. And so if you bring one thing back from this reunion, and I hope you do, be that you face the future with confidence and hope and love, because you are loved by the Mother of God, and she is on your side, she's your protectress. And you have the Holy Spirit, her spouse, behind you, and will be with you all the days of your life. And none of us know what the future holds. At 96, I know it's going to be short, but that's all I know. But I can say that I face the future as you can, with confidence and love, and certainly no fear, because the lady is with us, her spouse, the Holy Spirit, is with us. And when you have the Mother of God and the Spirit of God on your side, can't fail. You're home free. And so to all of you, I wish a very happy reunion. I know you will reach deep and pull up some of those wonderful aspirations of youth that were with you when you first came here and spent your years here studying and learning. I know that you will be filled with a kind of joy that life has had fulfillment for you because of what you learned here. But most of all, for now and for whatever days are ahead, you can walk with confidence because the Mother of God is your mother, my mother, and she is with us, and she's not going to let us fail. And if at times temptation looms large or problems seem insurmountable, just remember those simple words that Jesus gave his apostles. Come, Holy Spirit. It's a simple prayer, three words. But I guarantee you, you can't say that word without having suddenly in your life all of the power and force of God, all of the inspiration you will ever need, all of the strength to stand up and do what needs doing. And you can do all of this and still be in utter peace, knowing that God is with you. And so I wish you all a very happy reunion. I hope the happiness of seeing old friends and haunts that you dream about at times, of praying at the grotto and looking up at the dome, of remembering great professors and great friends and colleagues and classmates and hallmates, With all of this, I think will come an inner peace, because you're at home here, and you're at home with the good Lord that you all found here, but especially you're at home with Mary, the Mother of God. Our life, our sweetness, and certainly our hope.
Let us together confess our faith.